making his way to the glory ring, he moves up one notch to number 3 in the glory world rankings. Here is David Kiria.
David Kiria, 21-9, the 26-year-old from Georgia, has a 4-3 glory record and is the number 3 ranked lightweight.
He has a unique style. He's one of the pure karate fighters in glory, and he loves his karate background, and he uses it. The toughness of the knockdown karate, the body conditioning, like I said, with that great karateka of Simi Schilt, really works on that body hardening. Twice a week, he puts his gi on, and they go bare knuckle, and they go old school, which I think is tougher than actually kickboxing. It's really tough conditioning. What he's got to make sure he doesn't do in this fight is count on his toughness defensively. He needs to use his tough on the offense and beat this guy down with his conditioned body.
Kiria said he would like to win the title for karate.
This man shocked the kickboxing world with knockouts of Giorgio Petrosian and Robin Van Roosmalen at Glory 13 New York. Currently the number 1 ranked lightweight in the world, this is Andy Risty.
The number 1 ranked lightweight in the world of kickboxing. You can hear the engines revving for the machine, Andy Risty.
Well, this guy is a machine. He's a natural fighter. He doesn't think about what he's going to do. He does it. He goes in there and he fights from bell ding, bell dong.
Croatia and Glory 14. This is the first of 6 Glory title fights in 2014. Andy Risty meets David Kiria. And let's check out the tail of the tape.
The most important stat is the reach advantage for Risty. He can use that reach to sneak those punches in with his devastating power, and that could be the telltale, the reach in this fight.
Risty, the number 1 ranked lightweight in glory. For the introductions, back into the glory ring we go.
Introducing first, fighting out of the black corner, he was a 2009 Kyokushin champion with a black belt in Ashihara Karate. His professional record, 21 wins with 9 losses. Standing 5'7" tall, 1.70 meters, he weighed in at an even 153 pounds, 69.6 kilos, fighting tonight out of Georgia. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing David Kiria. Here now is his opponent, fighting out of the white corner, the reigning glory lightweight tournament champion. His record, 41 wins with 3 losses, 1 draw, undefeated in 6 prior glory appearances. Standing 5'11" tall, 1.80 meters. He weighed in at 153 pounds, 69.6 kilos. He fights tonight out of Suriname. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Andy the Machine Risty. Your referee for this contest is Al Wickers.
All right, fellas, this is for the Glory Lightweight World Championship. Command of victory, fight, protect yourself at all times. Obey my commands at all times. Fight clean, fight hard. Any questions, fighters? Hook them up, back to the corner, let's rock and roll.
The Glory World Lightweight Championship is on the line. And for this title fight, we will have 5 3-minute rounds, which is unique this year in the Glory World Series. Andy Risty in the green shorts, David Kiria in the black. They're ready to go. Al Wickers isn't yet. And now we are underway. Andy the Machine Christie, what an incredible year he had in 2013.
No feeling out. I love it. Now this is a title fight.
Coming out firing right away. Christie won the lightweight tournament, knocking off Petrosian and Van Roosmalen. Incredible way, really an improbable 2013. He's 6-0 in glory, looking to really prove that he last year wasn't a fluke and he deserves his title. Brothers clinch up.
Christie's got a unique style. He's almost a mix of the famous Prince Nassim Hamed from the 90s in boxing and as well Manny Pacquiao. He has a technically awkward style that a lot of people have a hard time timing.
Definitely unorthodox. Kyria gets a shot through there. Push kick missed by Kyria. And big shot there from Christie gets through. Under 2 minutes to go in round number one. Very athletic is Andy Christie. Uses his height and range really to his advantage in these fights.
And he's got a really good explosive first step. The first move is where he gets his explosion on his power shots. And we're seeing a different dynamic. Last fight he went righty. He started this fight right away lefty. He sees a hole in Kyria's guard.
Kyria just missed with a strong right hook. Now Christie counters. Two uppercuts.
It's that sneaky hook uppercut mix he likes. He's trying to go for broke with it.
Follows up those uppercuts with the knee.
I think Kyria's biggest advantage is his durability. As the fight goes on longer, the champion rounds in 4 and 5, you're going to see where Kyria's toughness is going to come in.
Under a minute to go in round number one. As Duke said, we are scheduled for 5 3-minute rounds. Fighters clinch and Al Wickers breaks them up. Andy Christie got a right that landed to the jaw of Kyria. Follows it up with a body kick. And that one might have been a little low.
That's one tough dude. He just scooped it off all dirty feet and all. Put his mouth guard back in. Let's do this.
The vacant glory world lightweight championship. Oh, a spinning kick just missed.
That's his signature rolling thunder kick. It comes from the karate where they roll forward and almost half cartwheel and try and knock you out with that downward heel.
It looks good, he just didn't land. Kyria comes into this fight with a 21-9 record. 6 KOs out of those 21 wins, or a 30% KO ratio. As we check out the total strikes, 21 thrown by Christie to 11 from Kyria.
We're going to take a look at that spinning kick that Kyria threw again. It's called the Rolling Thunder. He dives over and tries to whip that heel around. As he's midair, he whips his arm around, and that's what creates that whip. And if that thing lands, good night, Irene. That is a nasty kick.
Wow, bad intentions. Just misses, and you are right, Duke. That lands, it could be over. Round number two scheduled for 5 with the Glory World Lightweight title on the line. Andy Christie in the green and Daveed Kyria in the black. Left hook gets through from Christie. Fighters engaging and picking up the pace here in the second round. Body shot from Christie.
I was just gonna say, when you see Andy marching, what he's doing is, they call him Tai Yam Sam Kun. He's setting up the knees, and there he set it up there. You're gonna see him do it more.
We're back in it. Daveed Kyria, can he shake it off? Risty attacking now. Another knee. Smells blood. Three knockdowns in a round for a title fight equal to TKO. Four in the fight. Flying knee from Risty. Kyria comes back.
Very tough fighter. Again, the karate background. He's used to taking bare knuckles, bare shins, bare knees. There he is. He's setting up that knee as he marches. We'll see. He's going to turn his body so he can whip a knee in there. He's going to touch punching knee.
Kyria has a very aggressive style. No doubt about it. Off body shot from Risty. Risty going to work, but nice block from Kyria.
You can't wait with a guy like Risty because he's just so aggressive. He's going to get off on you. You won't be able to counter.
Risty 41-3-1 record. This misses with the combination.
He had a really good front kick up the middle, too. He split the guard with that. He's really good. A lot of his strikes are sneaky. They sneak in between your guard or around your guard. Very skilled at that.
Under a minute to go in round number two.
Also did a smart thing. He's starting to fake with the knees. You know he's worried about the knee, so he gets him to bite on the knee and hits him with something else.
You know, both these fighters are used to just fighting three-minute rounds. You got to pace yourself, too. Although Risty seems like he's just got one speed, and that's fast forward.
Now that was an explosive liver shot there. Again, he's always throwing for the knockout. There's that march again. Here come the knees.
Looking for his range, but Kyria gets a shot through. He has had some success with that straight uppercut from Risty, followed by the knee. And now, throwing leather is Andy Risty. And Kyria escapes.
We're going to get some looks at the knockdown here. Again, he was setting it up until he turned the knee into it. Not only did he knee up, he turned his hip and turned in and created a collision. He touches with the hand, moves the head with his hand into the knee.
How tough is the Kyria to
right
shake
hand,
that off?
He pulled the head in with his right, knee with the left. Beautiful knee, textbook. One more look at it. Again, here's that look. He cups his fingers. Bang.
Oh.
How did he survive that, man?
How did he not break his nose? Risty, known for his devastating knees, and there's a prime example of it. Tees him up with those body shots, too, to create the distance, and then moves in with brutal knees. Well, Daveet Kyria hangs on as we enter into round number three. Andy Risty and Daveet Kyria for the Glory lightweight title. All Risty in this one so far. Continues his combinations, follows him up with knees. Uppercut goes, gets through. Another hook.
Well, Risty's doing a good job. He's probing with strikes, and then he explodes. So he's keeping him busy like that. Touch, touch, crack. And that's how you're going to keep a counterfighter off you.
Throwing striking combinations and follows up with the knee.
Look, the power shot's all Risty. It's one-way traffic, 47%, 28 out of 60. He's just bombing.
Daveet Kyria, not known for his power, only six knockouts out of his 21 wins. But he got a nice left through to the head of Risty.
Ron,
see if he can follow it up.
I think he just heard you because he threw two big bombs. Three.
Under 2 minutes to go in round three. Body shot from Risty.
Risty does a really good thing. He just body shot it, then he controls the head well. That's what sets up either his hook or his knee or his low kick or body kick.
Now his straights are starting to land too. Christie, extremely athletic. Knees, strikes, goes a little bit of everything. Again, coming off two knockout wins over Robin Van Hoosmalen and number one ranked and pound for pound king, Giorgio Petrosian. Goes in the Glory Lightweight Tournament.
Nice front kick. You can see Kyrgios' right eye is starting to swell up from that knee and some of those hooks. You can see it's giving him a little trouble. But I like what Kyrgios doing. He's starting to wing the right hand. Before it was the hook early in the fight, I think he's going to find the right hand a little better because he's leaning back.
There's clinch. Oh, Kyrgios just misses with the high push kick. Here is getting close. He just can't land that spectacular shot. Again, the high push kick just missed. Oh, the spinning back kick to beat Kyrgios. It looks good. It didn't do much damage. As we wrap up round number three, David Kyrgios and Andy Ristie. Luke Thomas is standing by backstage.
I'm backstage here at Arena Zagreb, and I've got some news about our finalists in tonight's middleweight contenders tournament. As you can see behind me, Alex Pereira is hitting mitts. He looks pretty good. He had a pretty easy route to the finals, beating Dustin Jacoby by first round blistering KO, where he showed clearly demonstrably superior boxing. The story is a little bit different for the guy meeting him in the finals, Sahak Paparian. He had a really tough road to the finals. He has to face Alex Pereira, but he has to do so after fighting four rounds against Jason Wilmness. That was an extra round plus the three rounds regularly scheduled for their bout. When I saw him backstage, the doctor cleared him to go, but he looked visibly beat up. I'll have more news for you later. Back to you, Ron and Duke.
Thank you, Luke. Always a key in a tournament, Duke. We've said it over and over. To physically get out of that first round, you know, you want to get the win, of course, because you want to get to the finals, but to do it where you are healthy is always a key. We are ready for the championship rounds here for the Glory Lightweight title, Andy Ristie and David Kyrgios, round number four, scheduled for five. Despite some highlight reel misses from David Kyrgios, it's been all Andy Ristie so far. See if Kyrgios can mount a comeback here. And he gets a kick that knocks Ristie back. Kyrgios with the push kick, getting extremely close, could be finding his range.
One thing he's got to be careful about with those big kicks, the spin kicks, the push kicks, they take a lot of energy. So when they don't land, they're going to burn that gas tank.
And right now, he looks like he's on fast forward. Ristie gets a shot through to the face of Kyrgios.
Here's our total strikes, definite advantage. Ristie's landed 39%, but thrown 201 and landed 78.
Again, the spinning high kick from Kyrgios doesn't do much damage.
Again, getting back to those stats, the stats don't tell the story. Kyrgios' eye tells the story, right, Ron?
Exactly right. Kyrgios landed a counter shot to the side of the head of Ristie. Ristie continues to move forward. He's exchanging push kicks. Looks like Ristie is slowing it down a little bit here in round number four.
He's got to be careful. He had his feet together for a moment. If he gets hit with his feet together, he will get rocked.
That right eye of David Kyrgios definitely beginning to swell. And see, Ristie looks like he's targeting it with both his knees and his strikes. Under a minute to go in round number four.
There's the punch that went twice in New York, that sneaky uppercut hook. Great shot. Kyrgios, tough dude. Karate makes tough guys.
Absolutely. Andy Risty, though, knocking off the number one ranked and pound-for-pound king, Giorgio Petrosian in New York. Shocked the world, really. A lot of people were surprised by what he accomplished there. Andy Risty was not one of them. He expected to win, but many thought it was the biggest upset in kickboxing history.
I gotta tell you, Glory was it. Last year, 2013, was the year of upsets. Incredible fighters, incredible fights. And I think 2014 is going to see even a bigger year.
Kyria down on the mat again after missing with a high kick. And that's going to do it for round number four between Andy Risty and David Kyria.
Here's the Risty right hand, nice one. He just snuck it down the pipe. Again, trying to set that knee up with a hand. Again, comes right off the kick, plants his feet, and drives, and he pushes the head forward. When you push that head forward, it's like shooting a javelin. That's what makes that punch hard.
Our Glory girls are ready for this fifth and final round between Andy Risty and David Kyria.
Here we go.
Kyria wants to bring home the title. He needs to do something in spectacular fashion. Our fighters come out firing here in round number five.
Well, I tell you, Kyria, if he wants this fight, he's got to go for it. And definitely, Risty's got to be careful. We've had some interesting decisions. He's got to be careful not to just ride out on that knockdown. He's got to try and finish the fight or landslide round here.
At this point, how do you score this fight, Duke Rufus?
Right now, I give three rounds to one with the knockdown, but I could see it going 2-2, but with the knockdown, that's an extra point. So really, it moves it to 3-1. Yes, sir.
Here we go. One more time. Fight!
Approaching 2 minutes in the fifth and final round. Risty seemed to take it down a little bit in that fourth round, but picks up where he left off earlier. Now putting on a striking clinic.
Kyria is throwing hard shots, but he needs to just go for broke. Just swing till the bell rings. He needs to be Rocky in Rocky 1, 15th round. Go for it.
Power strikes are all Andy Risty, 33% landed. Kyria 16. Pace has definitely slowed in the fifth and final round.
Well, I tell you, I've had a couple fights like that.
Oh, David Kyria lands a couple big shots. Andy Risty is in trouble. Al Wicker steps in and will give Andy Risty the standing eight count.
The reason why that was called a knockdown, if the ropes saved you, that's still a knockdown. So if he would have fell down if the ropes weren't there, that's why I wasn't.
David Kyria going for the Hail Mary. Under a minute to go. The Glory lightweight title on the line. And down goes Risty. Second knockdown in the round. Three knockdowns in the fight. In the round. Four in a bout.
Six, seven, eight. You want to continue? Turn around, hands up. Fight.
Al Wickers lets his fight go. Kyria smelling blood. 30 seconds to go. Can Andy Risty hold on? Oh, David Kyria. Team up. He's down. Andy Risty falls down. David Kyria is your Glory lightweight champion. You've got to be kidding me. Incredible. Through the Hail Mary and completed it. David Kyria wins the title. Glory 14 rolls on. An incredible comeback by David Kyria. Andy Risty, not sure exactly what happened, had this fight in his hands until Kyria landed some incredibly hard shots.
Well, I tell you, heaven turned into heartbreak for him. I've been there, though, in those fights. You're feeling good, but those champion rounds. And when you got a guy who's in your face who wants it, and Kyria just wanted it. And he went, he got it, and wow. This is why we love Glory, man. It's always an upset. Why?
Well, you mentioned it, the championship rounds, because it looked like Risty gassed out as we take a look at the action.
It's that first hook that wrapped around the ear that rocked Risty, and then he came back with the right hand. What we're talking about, two guns a-blazing. There, that right hand hook, and he's got him doing the sloppy chicken there. And again, he fell into the ropes. That's a knockdown. Second knockdown, right hand dips over, left hook. That again, that left hook rocked him, and right on the jawline. Right hand over the top. Again, what was impressive, he was punching hard while getting punched at. Here's the third knockdown, went for the front kick, but this is all she wrote. Left hook, comes back left, right hand, and boom, big left hook. Going for it, stayed on it. Bang, right hand, left hook, and again, just nonstop barrage. Buried him with that left hook at the end. It was that right hand going downward, left hook coming up that rattled him. Look at the hunger here to finish. A closer, ABC, always be closing. Right hand chopped him, and now look, he brings him back up with his left hook. That's what was bad. You knock his head one way, knock him back the other, and that's how you close the show and why he is the Glory World Champion.
Incredible performance by David Kyria. The timing there was incredible. You see a lot of times where the guys see that they have hurt their opponent and just come in wildly swinging, but you said it, Duke. He really picked his moments, pushed out, created distance, and was able to land and finish the fight.
Well, that's why he's been at the top of the Glory rankings for a while. You know, he's been right there and he needed this, and he finally, persistence paid off, and his tough karate background showed, and we went into the later rounds. As I said earlier in the fight, that's where we're gonna see Kyria shine. In the later rounds, and he did. He's repping Georgia with his Georgian warrior beard on. Big props to this man.
He said he wanted to win one for karate, and David Kyria accomplished that tonight. Never say never. An incredible finish here at Arena Zagreb for the Glory lightweight title. What a comeback from David Kyria.
Huge knee. I don't know how he got up from that. He took some big knees later. That eye was closing. Again, another Rocky story. Just, that's what we do here at Glory. Comeback city. He was taking shots, took another knee, but again, he was eating them. His karate toughness paid off. He took some big blows, but here's where the tide turned. Kyria knew he had to go for it. The overhand right clipped him and knocked him back one way with the hook. And he took out the big tournament champion to become the world champion.
It was all Andy Risty early, but David Kyria finished it. Let's make it official and go to Tim Hughes.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have an official time of 2 minutes, 22 seconds of the fifth and final round. This one ruled a knockout for your winner, and now Glory Lightweight World Champion, David Kyria! We would like to welcome into the ring the mayor of Zagreb, Milan Bandic, who hands the belt over to our head of talent operations, Cor Hemmers, and our Glory chairman, Pierre Onderon.
All right, I'm here with David Kyria, the new Glory World Lightweight Champion. David, how does that sound?
I'm happy.
You happy?
I'm happy.
David, it was a tough fight. Was there ever a moment where you thought it was going to slip away, where the fight was getting away from you, especially with that knockdown from the knee?
Thank you, especially for best fight to the Risti. He was my opponent, but I respect him as person, as champion. Thank you.
David, are you more interested in fighting the next contender, or do you want to give Risti a rematch?
We will see. I don't think about that. I'm happy. I'm sorry. I won't say thank you very much, especially for my Georgian trainer. He's like father. He's, I don't know. He's my kumir. Thank you, Dave, Sam, Oz.
Congratulations, David. Everyone here is amazed. You're the new Glory World Lightweight Champion, David Kiria, ladies and gentlemen.